the world make over. Mashiach will come take over. You ain't gotta be me or see what I see. All you gotta do is take a look forward. Lift up your eye to the sky, spread out your hands, say thank you, smile. Get them up, put them up, leave them up, ha ha. Yep, yep, pump up the volume every day. Stand in place, heart racing, no words to say. Pressure building, trying to hold my face. Mind drifting like not today. Wake up from everything. Break out your shell and scream. Ha, Shim, you're the king. Ha, Shim, you're the king.
Hashem Elech, Hashem Malach, Hashem Imloch Leolam Va'em. Hashem Elech, Hashem Malach, Hashem Imloch.
Welcome, everybody. Welcome, everybody, to the Lighthouse Project, opening season 4, the Year of Netzach, opening concert. My name is Michael Ben Malach. I'm the director of the Lighthouse Project. Thank you. And we have a great show planned for all you guys tonight, and we're so excited to bring this to Miami. We have 3 amazing acts, but before we talk about the acts, I really want to thank the sponsors who've helped put this crazy, amazing show that you guys are going to witness tonight. Miami really hasn't seen stuff like this before, and really we need to thank a lot of different people who helped make this happen. So, first of all, the Beit David Haim Lake Shul, where this is all going down. Again, you can see the beautiful, what we can do in something in a space like this. Thank you very much. Kass, up in North Miami Beach, a brand new shul that opened up a year ago. A lot of good people in that shul. God bless you guys. Thank you so much. I want to thank Tzaddik Management for helping out as well. We Are One, putting together all the flyers and the artwork. Thank you so much. Three Nom, putting together all the different tags you guys are wearing. Takiya Productions. The Kopelman family, thank you so much for putting together something like this. And of course, the Neshama Foundation for all the good work that you guys do. Thank you so much. So, the first artist we're going to present right now is something, whether you do know or you don't know, this guy is bringing new music, new style of music into the Jewish world. He's not only an up-and-coming artist, he's already, as it is, very well known up in the North, and I had to bring him down here to the South, bring him to Miami, expose him to you guys. And he comes from the holy city of Crown Heights, and he's about to rock you guys out of here. So, with that being said, Rafi.
How's everybody doing? All right, all right. I'd like to first start with expressing some Hakarat HaTov to the Highland Lakes community and to the Lighthouse Project for having me. It's really a pleasure and an honor. When I heard about what the Lighthouse Project is about, being a light in the Or L'Goyim and even the Or L'Achim and the Or to our brothers, to find light and to find hope and know that there is a place to dock when we're out here in this ocean is a beautiful idea to me. And I'm so blessed to be a part of it. So I'd like to welcome everybody to my musical journey. My name is Rafi, AKA Hebrew. My music is my mission. I'm born in Crown Heights to parents that are Gerim. My parents converted 49 years ago. And I was raised to be a soldier in a sense, to be out here and to take the talents that Hashem has given me in order to shed light and to spread positivity. I'm a hip hop artist, and it's my mission to take hip hop and make it into a positive, progressive thing. I think it's powerful. And it's my pleasure to share it with you. This first track is my song about Mashiach. It's called Redemption. I think it's a universal idea. I think everybody could agree with it, no matter where you come from or what you believe in, the idea of unity and brotherhood. So without further ado, this is my song about Mashiach.
I wanna sing a redemption song, a song of freedom in the rising sun. Sing a song about the day gone come. The day gone come. Harmony with a voice so strong, it won't be long till we sing as one. The day has come.
the day has come.
I wanna sing a redemption song, a song of freedom in the rising sun. Sing a song about the day gone come. The day gone come. Harmony with a voice so strong, it won't be long till we sing as one. The day has come.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I wanna sing a song about redemption. When I pick up the mic, I'm hoping I can grab your attention. Take the first step on my lyrical mission, revealing what's hidden. Sing about a reason for living, a season of giving. Got to use this rap session, make an impression, teach a man a positive lesson, give him my blessing. The world don't stop testing, we get knocked down, but remember to keep stepping. We not the first, and we won't be the last. The only way we survive is to learn from the past. Make it my task, come on, clap your hands with me. The time is now, get up and take a stance with me. So many slain, fighting pain, living against the grain. Waiting for the sun, we learn to dance in the rain. Back against the ropes, taught the folks about hope. Dr. King had a dream about the world we know. Back in the day, they hate and say the vision was crazy. Look around today, appreciate the gift that he gave me. The battle is won, one step at a time. I'm on the front line fighting, and my weapon's my mind. My nine is my rhyme, seen because I'm seeing the signs. I see the top of the mountain, and I'm ready to climb. And if I decide that I live by it, turn me up, cause I can't stay quiet. Chosen few, get in the booth, let loose. Pick up the mic and show them what the truth could do. Eyes on the prize, drop your rhyme worldwide. But don't lie, so that the truth don't die. New breed of MCs, rap about unity of you and me, discovering peace. Do your thing on the beat, stand with me. If you ready to sing, I wanna sing a redemption song.
Song of freedom
and the rising sun. Sing a song about the day gone come. The day gone come. Harmony with a voice so strong, it won't be long till we sing as one. The day has come. The day has come. I wanna sing a redemption song. A song of freedom, rising sun. Sing a song about the day gone come. The day gone come. Harmony with a voice so strong, it won't be long till we sing as one. The day has come. The day has come.
The day has come, the day is right now.
The day has come.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. This next track is, you know, now that we've sung a little bit about the idea of Mashiach, the next question is the Hishtadlut. What exactly are we gonna do to make that happen? It's a nice idea, it's a nice goal, but exactly what are we gonna do about it? And if it was up to us, we should maybe think about it. And if it was up to me to make all the difference in the world, what would I do, even the smallest thing? My commander-in-chief, the Rebbe, definitely let me know that even the smallest thing is the greatest thing when it comes to doing anything to bring Mashiach. So, with that, this is my next track. And don't be afraid to come up and dance if you want to, because that's the kind of music I make. Let's do it.
Together we can make it right.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Together we can make it right. Together we can make it right.
Right, how would it feel?
all one team, one peace, one love, one massive party. We want freedom, can't stand beside me. Too strong when we come, we never stop. We want conversation, come we ride. Come stand beside me, too strong when we come, we never stop me. Together make it paradise. Together we can make it right. We gotta make it right. Together make it paradise. Together we can make it right.
Thank you. Awesome. You guys are great. You guys are great. All right, my next track is called Hallelujah. Take Tehillim and put a hip-hop twist on it.
Thank you very much.
guys are awesome. You guys are awesome. You guys are awesome. You guys are awesome. All right.
Thank you. Thank you. So my next track, I honestly and truly believe that when I write music, Hashem gave me a unique skill set. And part of making my music is to spread a message of unity. And I think Hashem gave us the answer to that in Bereshit, which we read about a couple weeks ago. So I wrote a song about the enormity of that lesson, and it's called Soldiers. Can y'all help me out though? I need to meet up.
Soldier, young warrior, fight for one love. It's a salute to my soldier.
Yeah.
It's a salute to my soldier. Young warrior, fight for one love. It's a salute to my soldier.
Yeah.
It's a salute to my soldiers. Words can never express it the best to what I owe you. Can't say I ever put my life on the line. Pay my tribute when I sit in the booth and write rhymes for the soul. Look, without further ado, you sang a song about the strong with the miraculous view. You asking me who? I'm trying to get a grasp of the truth. Where we been, who we are, where we trying to get to. You want to understand a sixth grand story of man, but you can't. So you looking back at where it began. A world set in motion, rivers, valleys, mountains, ocean, forever alive. Hitting with this, you can get to know him and stay to set. Mankind standing erect, with intellect, face the rest above the heart of your chest. Man to give a breath, to be the crest of the process. Mission to chase with the definition of progress. But in his haste, man had to have a taste. Decided that he would try it, but trying to geonize despite it. Never got it, greatest lesson of all. You can never know it all, and now he's terrified by it. Now he's terrified by it. Keeper is a real good question. I see the truth in a pasuk when it reads, how am I supposed to know where he goes? It's not me. I hear the echo, lo yadati, cause what he didn't know is supposed to remind me. Don't forget to keep a place for the face. Know the only way is to make space beside me.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you very much. Now, this next track is, again, one of my favorites, which is to take David HaMelech's music, to take David HaMelech's words and add a hip-hop flavor to it. Because, honestly, King David was the greatest rapper of all time. Like, of all time. And his music, if you listen to his words with a hip-hop beat, it rhymes, the poetry is perfect. And so I like to take that and make music with it. And I actually feel like I relate with King David because King David's story is very much like, has a lot of parallels to my own and being an Evan Ma'asu HaBonim and knowing that no matter what, Hashem's got you and Hashem's with you. So this next track is called Shamreni. It's the first installment in, I'm gonna be doing Tikkun HaKlali, and this is the first one.
The delight of my life to try to understand you. Cause it's the mighty trying to fight through the night, reaching for light, keeping the most high close by. Keep my open eye at night. This is my pleasant lot of nachalash and fry light. I praise the one who counsels me.
Yeah. Shiviti Hashem, the Negdi Tami, Kimamini. You stand by my right hand, you with me. Bale Moat, when these waves rock this boat, my hope and use the reason why I'm staying afloat. Cause I know you never let my soul go to Sheol. I've seen it and I'm believing the meaning of being whole. Until I write my letter in the scroll, I'ma grab this mic, get to spitting light, and I ain't letting go.
Keep protecting me, hold me close, I know you can let me. Elki, Kasiti Bach. Because you're my shot, so I know it's nothing that you can't do. Is it the line of my life to try to understand you? This is somebody trying to fight through the night, reaching for light, keeping the most high close by.
Todi Annie or Achai, and me let me know the ways of life, so I'ma stand by. So I see my hope, when I'm in your presence, got me counting brachot. My hope is well, help me cope when I walk in a tightrope. I'm in your right hand, the kind of pleasure that don't stop. No, I won't drop. You my prop to the hilltop. Never flip-flop, connect dots with hip-hop. I know I'll never let me see the shachat. I know I'm safe, I know you got me, you're strong, levita.
So I release a slow sigh. Got open eyes, protect my soul, don't tie so nafshi. I know you watching over the road of your chassid. To feel invested every single step, never stress. Know that you directing me. I'm ready. Protecting me, hold me close, I know you can let me. Elki, Hasiti Bach, you keep me safe and go because you're my shout out. No, it's nothing that you can't do. Try to understand you. This is the mighty soul, fight through the night, reaching for light, keeping the most high close by.
Tony, Yeni, Arachai. Tony, Yeni, Arachai, my mind. Yeah, and I know, yeah, I know you got me so, I know you got me so, and I never know when I'm hitting down low, when I'm feeling low. Shalom, Rainy, keep protecting me.
No, it's nothing that you can't do. This is the light of my life to try to understand you. Cause it's somebody trying to fight through the night, reaching for light, keeping the most high close by.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. This next track is a rendition of one of my favorite Jewish singers, the Pia Menta Band. So I took one of their tracks and remixed it a little bit. It's called Gila Rina. If you know it, sing it, please.
Ah, 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 ah
Thank you, thank you. So, this last track is called Gam Ki Elech, which is the first music video. Psalm Chaf Gimel 23.
Lift my soul, hold me down, put the crown back on my head. Yan Chaney, lead me in the path of the righteous. Bless my mind, divine rhyme when I write this. Show me the way for your namesake, and let it be told. Trying to make it to the top so that the world should know. Then my Aunt Shemo.
Yan Kiele, Ki ata ima gam ki elech Ege'et ha-mamed lo i'ara Ki ata
Now as I walk through the valley in the shadow of death Gam ki elech begets on my vet Take a deep breath And let the melody steady me. I'll be leaving doubt behind. I keep the truth ahead of me. Ready as I'll ever be. Can't tie my deep. I gotta dig deep, seeking a peace inside of me. And when I find it, gotta find a way to stay reminded. I'm blinded. Wish there was a way I could rewind it. I know it takes a lot of work, but I don't mind it. I bind it and grind for time and keep rhyming. I read the task of old and get lifted, gifted. Coming to this world, try to fix it. Ain't nothing to it but to do it, you and me. So David wrote a piece, sing Psalm 23. Cause we've been on a mission over centuries. Every soul, a piece of the puzzle, gotta add my piece.
Yom ki ele, beget ama velo irara. Ki ata ima, yom ki ele, beget ama velo irara.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. Let's hear it for the Lighthouse Project. Well, thank Michael and the Ben Meleks for making all this happen and everyone else who's involved. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. It was my pleasure playing for you guys.
You guys all are wearing these bands. Can I get a yes? I'm wearing these bands. So I think it's important for everybody to understand a little bit about what the Lighthouse Project means, its mission, and our goal. And this band has two different words on it. It says Lighthouse, and it says Emunah. And the concept of a lighthouse, for those that don't know what a lighthouse even is, which you should, but a lighthouse is a building that's over the water that helps guide boats that are offshore to help them and bring them back inside, bring them back in safety. And the concept of the lighthouse being representative of what Torah is, and the waters also representing Torah. And what we're here to do is to try to inspire and try to bring back safely as many Jews back to Hashem. That is our goal. And one of the ways that we do it is with the concept of Jewish unity. And what we believe is that by having all different types of Torah coming from different type of teachers, whether they're Ashkenazic, Sephardic, Chabad, Breslov, Hasidish. Did I miss any? I missed a lot of other ones, but the point of the matter is that everybody can learn a little bit from all different types of Judaism. And who knows, maybe you'll be inspired by learning something new that might affect your neshama, it might affect your soul to get back to Hashem. And that's the goal of Lighthouse Project. And this year being the fourth season of Lighthouse Project, I'm happy to say that the Lighthouse Project is about to go on very, very ambitious endeavors. But before I even talk about that, I just want to quickly say why you're wearing this bandit, what it means, and why when you wear it, if you do wear it, it means a lot. The word lighthouse, as I mentioned to you, what it is and what it does, the reality is that we are all lighthouses. We have the ability to affect and help so many Jews to get back to Hashem. And it's important to know that. It's important that we all have that power within us to affect so many people. And so whenever you're in that mode and you feel like you can actually make a difference, do a special mitzvah, give a quick chizuk to somebody, you're in lighthouse mode. So the lighthouse is right in front of you. But the reality is in life, life is not always so great and nice, and there's ups and there's downs. And when there's downs, and it's hard to give chizuk to somebody else because you need chizuk for yourself, there's only one thing you can do, and that's have pure emunah and have pure faith. And when a person has pure faith and has pure emunah, a person can actually just look towards God and strengthen themselves. When once they strengthen themselves, you can go back to lighthouse mode and affect, again, other people. And that's what this band is all about. So I hope that whoever is wearing it, take what I'm saying and inspire yourself, whether you're in lighthouse mode or you're on emunah mode. Emunah mode is something that everybody should have 24 hours a day, but from the basis of what I'm saying, it's important that this is what his wristband is all about. So I hope you guys enjoy it, and I hope you take that for yourself. And now, ladies and gentlemen, so before I introduce this next artist, who I'm a big, big fan of, this guy, not that long ago, I stumbled upon his music. He's very big up also in the North. He's lives in Muncie, but he lives also in Baltimore. He's part of the Shabbat.com program, CDs. So if there's any single ladies out there, please talk to me first, because I would want to make the shit up. I want Olam Haba. Okay, that being said, ladies and gentlemen, the sweet sounds of Penny Schachter.
What's going on, everybody? How's everybody doing? It is such an honor and pleasure to be here. We got to get this guitar going. So I showed up on Thursday. Some nice warm weather. It's starting to get cold down in Baltimore, New York. So I decided I was gonna run to the beach from Highland Lakes. So I ran all the way to Bayside Village. It took me an hour and a half. And someone's like, you're in the wrong place. So I ran an hour the other way, got to the beach. And I laid down for 3 hours and passed out. That's my Florida experience, but it's so good to be here. This is my good friend Shmuel Weinfeld. We're gonna play some music for you tonight. Yeah. stand. And I'm blinded by my own truth. Life will pass me by if I don't open up my heart. That's fine by me. So maybe you guys so much. So me and Shmuel were in yeshiva together in Israel, and we had the most musical group of people you've ever seen in your life. So we'd be learning in the middle of first aid, and everyone would just stop and go to the back of the room with our guitars and our bongos and just start jamming. And Rabbi Brazil would come out and look at us and just be like, all right, whatever, do your thing. Okay. This next song was written by Moshav Band. It's one of my favorite songs. It's called Don't Give Up. And it's pretty self-explanatory, so I'll let the song speak for itself. I know. song. So, people were asking me, like, what are you gonna play? And I told them I have no idea. I get up on the stage and whatever I'm feeling, that's what I play. So we haven't played together in like 3 years, and I didn't prepare this set list. So everything you're hearing is from my heart to your heart. I heard Shlomo Katz, Eitan Katz, his brother, and I was listening to him and he said, I'm gonna share something from my heart, because how could something that's not in my heart go into your heart? So everything I'm playing right now is just straight from my heart. So we say this in davening every Maariv. We ask Hashem, no matter what I've done, don't take your love away from me. Because we all mess up, right? We all, sometimes we look at ourselves and we're like how could I, you know? And then we're like, Hashem, like, why do you, but we ask Hashem, like, always love me. So that's what this song is about. For their mother who had cancer. It's a really special song, and it's about not being afraid, because Hashem loves me. If Hashem loves me, how could I be afraid of anything? It's easy to say, it's hard to live by, but it's real. The more you think about it, like, if God really loves me, then I can be a little bit less afraid. Maybe just a little bit.
Smiley Gabriel, if I'm not a real,
When I sing that song, sometimes I have to like watch myself so I don't start crying like on stage. Again, it's so awesome to be here. And sometimes performers like to talk when they're performing, they're singing, like to like say their piece. But sometimes they go on too long and everyone's sitting there going, come on, like keep playing. But I just wanted to share one thing that I found in my life at least. Is that the relationship with Hashem is real, but sometimes we're taught that being close to Hashem is just for the rabbis, it's for the priests, it's for the holy people, but it's not for me. Like, I can't have my own personal relationship with Hashem. Like, that's not really real. Like, you could even be like, oh, that's so weird. Like, me close to God, like, talk to God, that's so weird. But when we start doing it, at least when I started doing it, my whole life started to change. Started to talk to God in English, on my own, go to the forest by myself. I'm not a hippie, just love talking to God. But it's a real thing, and I noticed that there's two things that hold us back from talking to God. There's for sure more, but two things I noticed was either that God doesn't love me enough because I'm like not so good, right? I do the wrong thing, or I'm this and that, or I don't think I'm special. I don't think there's anything, like who am I? So like, what's the point? Like, hey, God's amazing, but like, I'm nothing. I'm just a little, whatever. I do my thing. It's the most false thing in the world. Someone told me once, he's like, the day you were born, God decided that this world could not go on without you. The day you were born, God was like, this world cannot go on without you, and without you, and without you. God, you have to be here. When you think about that for a minute, like, what a smile does, you know? What a good morning does. It's crazy. Like, the amount you can impact this world is nuts. It's crazy. There's people everywhere, and there's so much to be done. There's so many good things to do, and we can, each one can do, we can all do it. But we think, oh, I'm not so important, no, I can't really do it. Like, forget that. You're incredible. You're, like, nuts. So. Children will play one day. Basically played songs that nobody knows anyway, so it wouldn't have mattered. I wrote this song about a couple weeks ago, and I was going through a rough time, as artists always do. We're always going through a rough time. It doesn't matter when you see us, we're always going through a rough time. And that's when the best music comes out. And I was feeling this emotion of, I know the kids are screaming, but it's okay, don't worry about it. This emotion of I want to be so good. I want to be so great. I want to be so holy and beautiful and close to God. And I want to be so loving. And I had this rezon to be just so much more than I am. And I sat down by the piano, so I wish I had a piano up here. And I wrote this song about just knowing that I'm so amazing inside, and I want to connect with that. And I don't want to let anybody or anything in the world try to tell me that I'm not a holy soul, I'm not a beautiful soul, I'm not a special soul. Because anyone that tries to, the world tries to say, oh, whatever, like we said before, it's not that important. It's garbage, it's not true. So I wrote this song. And I hope people in the audience, you can pay attention even though it's pretty loud in here, but. open wide and my eyes to the sky, begging for a reason why. And suddenly a voice called my name, said, why you standing alone in the rain? I hear you, I feel your pain. Tonight, after the most amazing concert by Nissim Black, you walk out there and you know that you're a soul on fire, always and forever. Nobody can take that away from you. Laila Tov, everybody.
Music up! The final redemption.
The push, the lift, you got only fly if you're falling off a cliff. Everybody, come on. Hands up, hands up, hands up. This is safe place. Hey. Stars, come on. Lift off, lift off. Look down, look down. I need more music. Guess with me. Still waiting with more patience. This victory is more sacred. When you're waiting, by the owner, and with the trover, a controller. You are not a robot. You feel impossible because you're locked in a box. But you can take the lid off and see me on the sauce and hear a pin drop if you're listening. Scream forward, you can even scream forward. You can paint the picture even if you reach forward. The grind, push, lift. You can only fly if you're falling off a cliff. Miami!
Thank you. Send my gratitude, my love to two guys that, this is my knowledge, I know there were other sponsors and everybody, but I really were responsible for making this happen. First off, everybody give some love and some noise to Michael Bemelik, the Lighthouse Project. And also, this cannot have been done without the man behind the speaker. Make some noise for Ellie Copeland also, to everybody. Let's tell Lamala.
Everybody ready?
How's everybody? You guys ready? From the top of me. You guys, listen. I just got back. I was in Baltimore with my good friend Guy Elbaz. Then we went from Baltimore all the way to Pennsylvania. Then I went and did 3 days in New York. Then I got off the plane in Florida, and I felt like I had just walked into a sauna. So my assumption was that it must be that everybody here in Florida works out a little bit, you know? So I came to give you a nudge. Right now we're in Zumba class, okay? You guys ready? Okay, make it work together. The song, sing along. Is this me? I need more music in the mind of this place. Yeah, listen.
Call me Nissim, or you can call me Nissim. Call up whatever, just come call it Nissim. I will admit that back then I was a beast. Seemed like a villain for that big white sheet. And a small belly cat to double B. A fit, see it's putting up on the stick. Put it all in. Get whatever you can get and take a sip and let it sit. They get it quick, look. Plus when I had something, and I'm back focused. Now it's in the open, it's in the spin. I left the corner like I was receiving. Now that I came back, now that I had to bring it. Cause they don't believe it, cause they don't believe what the beauty of their heart. They're only thinking. They set me on this earth to a purpose. It probably isn't true. If letting it isn't working, come on.
Thank you.
so amazing what Hashem could do. Vicar is such a Milo, call yourself. But even when the world is still full of shakram, what they don't know about Kosra, we mamish, B'nai Emuni, full of Amuna, even in the darkest times. So I want to tell you something I heard, more different work. More different work. So we sing sometimes, most of us would like to sing Zimros. We sing,
I'm gonna get it. you know that if you can be damaged, they believe you can fix it. Do you believe that? If you can break it, you can fix it.
Yeah.
When I heard that, it hit me in my heart, and I decided to write the song with a beautiful actress and colleague, Serena Mariaja. If you know the song, please sing along with me.
Yeah.
First, you gotta show me your behavior now, huh? One of them is, when I was unsure whether or not, after started learning Judaism and got involved in the Yiddishkeit, if I would return to music or not, I was more sure that I would do it. If there was one person who was pushing me, and he pushed me, and he kicked me, and he body slammed me, it's like he really could go home. When he appears in every single one of my videos, he's here somewhere tonight. Everybody make some noise for Uncle Rick.
I wanna fly, fly away.
voice I've been sharing on stage. Something very dear to my heart. Almost 2 years ago, listen, this is very, very important. Almost 2 years ago, when we shared me and my family had the wonderful opportunity to make Aliyah, and now we live in Jerusalem. And I remember I went to the post-it of the yeshiva that I was learning on, very sweet. I was learning in a certain yeshiva, and I went to the post-it of that yeshiva. And I told him, listen, and my wife, ever since we got here, because we moved there in the middle of the school year, and he told the rabbi, I said, listen, everybody's got horror stories about sending their kids to school, and I don't know what school to send my children to. So the rabbi said to me like this, you guys have to listen. He said it from his love. He said, Nissim, I want to tell you something. I'm going to be very, very honest with you. He said, you got a lot of things against you. He said, the first thing is that you're black. Yeah. You're Jewish. You're a faucet. You're a breast lover. He said, listen, you got a lot of chesronos. And I remember when every single thing that he said, I'm like sinking into the chair, you know, living here. So I got back home, and I'm sitting in my chair, and I started to talk to Hashem. And I asked Hashem, thank you for all my chesronos, all my lacking. I said, but Hashem, any minus, any greatness, what's my godless? This is my weakness, what's my godless? And you know what Hashem revealed to me? My old boss, I had this thought that I was black, I'm a gay, I'm a Jew, I'm a chassid, I'm a person. It's mamish, and that place of that nakuda where we feel the most lacking, where we feel that we suffer from a lack of greatness, that's exactly where our godless is. Because in that place, there's no godless, only Hashem. Only Hashem. So, this person back here, my brother-in-law, best friend since kindergarten, Joseph Brown. From all the hits you guys are hearing, not only did he produce the music, but he published, wrote amazing songs you love to sing, Fly Away, Millionaires, Yaka. So, without further ado, I'll give us some kavod on this one, this beautiful song that my brother-in-law wrote for me. You guys gonna know the song? You guys sing along with me?
Yeah.
They are a mission. He said to me, would you like to do a remix? You got no money for yourself. So I said, okay. He said, I'll call you back. He called me a little while later. He said, listen, I talked to God, we're doing this. And I got an email, had these files, and I put the song in. I started rapping to the music, which is original music. Then he called me back and he said, listen, the whole song, it ran nice, the beat's kind of outdated, we need something new, something fresh. So I called my friends at Robot Jackson in Seattle, and I said, let's do this. A little while later, I got a call from a guy named Kyle Buzz. And he called me, we're on the phone and we're talking, and he revealed to me, he said, listen, if this original song, it's not really my type of song. He said, but it was a non-Jewish song before. And I said, wow. Because I have a principle. I don't take non-Jewish songs and then remake them over. That's not my principle. So I went out to go talk to Hashem. I said, what do I do? Do I go along with the song or do I not go along with the song? In the midst of that conversation, he told me that this song was originally composed by an Algerian Arab French guy. He's an Arab. And I remember standing on the dock in Super Park, and I was looking at the water, and I was reminded of a Torah I lived with my mom. And I said, it's very good when the Jews sing the song, the anthem of the nation that's afflicting the Jewish people. We see this in all of the songs that we're singing, learning, Yom Kippur, Rosh Hashanah, all the Poland art songs, the Russian art songs we're singing. The good thing that came from him, we're about to explain it, that this song has the power to go up the shrine and cause this show for all the clients around. So I got all this on his lap, and I swore from thinking about maybe yes or no to being honest, and I have to go through this song. So I went to New York and we did it, and after the song came out, I came and did it to tell you the salvations Yeshua that I received in my whole life from the song. And someone said to me later on, after I told him the story, he said, that's interesting. He said, because the gematria of Hashem Alech, Hashem Alech, Hashem Nimloch, is gematria of Mashiach. Yeshua from Klal Yisrael, we're singing in the gooding of the nation that's afflicted with us, we can all sing to bring Mashiach together. You guys ready to do that?
Yeah. Yeah. Nissim Black!